Hi, I'm from Germany, and I'd say German bread is better than French baguette. Today I am going to show you how to create invasion animations in DaVinci Resolve Fusion using my script Map Engine. To start off, go to the Fusion preferences and make sure that under frame format you have selected the correct frame rate and resolution. Fusion is frame based, not time based, so you can change the frames per second after the fact, but it is better to set up everything correctly from the get-go. Setting up the correct resolution is more important, as this will be the default size for added background nodes, renderers, and so on. Now that this is set up, go to the menu bar, search for script, and start Map Engine. Here I use the same resolution as set in the frame format settings, then continue to select the satellite map. Map Engine automatically builds the node flow and the main UI appears. Here, search for Europe to move to this location. This is a bit close, so open the navigation panel and zoom out by 2x. Click on the top right button in the function row to open the GeoJSON system. This opens a selection window where you can select a GeoJSON file that contains all countries. I'll leave a link in the description where you can download one for yourself. The script automatically lists all GeoJSON contained in the file. In my case, it is all countries as low resolution polygons. In the search bar, search for France. Click on the checkbox, then search for Germany and also select it. When you clear the search bar, you can see all the shapes you have selected. Left click on a free space in your node flow. Unfortunately, Fusion's API does not allow for specific placement of polygon nodes, so they kinda appear where you last left clicked. Now in the UI, draw them out separately. Map Engine draws out the shapes and automatically connects them to the node flow. We'll come back to this later, but now let's build the invasion mask. Drag in a background node and click on Selected Node to View in the UI. This button anchors any 2D or 3D node to the main node system. Drag in a fast noise node and merge the background over the fast noise. Then add a transform node after the merge node. Connect this transform into the image plane. Add another transform node after the fast noise. Now drag in an ellipse mask and connect it into the mask inputs of the background and fast noise. Scale down the ellipse and then select the fast noise's transform node to scale it up slightly. In the ellipse node, increase the soft edge value to blend the two shapes together. Now adjust the detail, contrast, and scale values inside the fast noise. For detail, I've gone all the way up to 10, for contrast around 2.4, and lastly for scale, all the way up to 20. To make the noise move, slightly increase the teeth rate. Now check if the mask still covers the whole country. In my case, the top of Germany is not covered. To fix this, go to the image plane and increase the scale. Now we use the setup to mask Germany. Drag the image anchor renderer output into the mask input of Germany's feature anchor renderer. If you drag the renderer into the viewer, nothing happens, because black means not masked. Now select the transform node in the masking setup. Move the pivot point to approximately where the border between Germany and France is. You can check how close you are by using the scale value. In my case, I have to move it slightly closer towards the middle. Let's start with the animation. Go to the start of your comp and set a keyframe. Then move 150 frames ahead and set another keyframe. Go back to the first keyframe and set its value to 0. If you now play the animation, you will see the mask animating on. But don't forget to disconnect the image anchor renderer from the merge above it. We don't want the mask to be rendered in our final animation. Select the extrude 3D nodes and go to the material tab to change the color from white to red. And to make it look nicer, go to the feature merge and change the apply mode to multiply. I am happy with how this looks, so let's animate the map. To make this easier, open the navigation panel and change the pitch and orbit values. When you are happy with the framing, click on the keyframe button in the UI. Now move to the end of the invasion animation. I want the map to pitch even more and orbit around Germany. Also, let's zoom in by 2x. And a bit of repositioning is also needed. Save this position by clicking on the keyframe button. The animation is still linear. Select CompCon and open the spline tool. Change the mode to Show Only Selected. select all keyframes and hit S on the keyboard. When you are happy with how it looks, click on the muffin to bake the animation. Map Engine will now go through every frame and determine what tiles are needed at what position and automatically download and place them. Then, in a second pass, it keyframes the blending between the different map detail levels. When it's done, the map will satisfyingly snap to the final high-quality image. Lastly, it is time to render the animation. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching and goodbye.